YouTube, so I'm gonna do probably a time lapse, or not really a time lapse, but just I'm gonna fast, or not fast forward. I'm just gonna pick up the speed through the parts where I'm working, which is probably gonna be most of it. And basically, I decided that I'm going to transfer all this stuff to this, to the drag bike. I went and picked up the tube and the chain lube, or not the chain lube, the clutch cable lube, so I can lube up the clutch. Because you guys, I don't know if you guys can see, but really, really hard to pull it, and it gets notched up a lot. So I'll show you guys how to do that whenever I get to that point. But right now, my main point is just going to be to get the engine and all the running components on here. Then I'll get the rest of it done after that. So I'm gonna start taking apart the bike. It'd be helpful if I could find my screwdriver. It does not seem that I have that in here. I will be back. Alright guys, so I'm going to show you guys how to do this cable lube. I bought the kit because it's just cheaper from Cycle Gear. If you buy the kit rather than buying the tool and the spray separate. But I think the only cable spray that they do have is Cable Life. And they have, and you need this tool of course, which they have. But which is a little nicer. I mean, I haven't used it, so I don't know for sure, but it just looks nicer. But that's $12, and this is like 7 or whatever. This and that together was 23. But then if you were to buy these separate, it's like 25 or something, so you save a couple bucks. I mean, if you guys really are picky about your tools, you gotta have super nice tools, and I guess go with the other one. But this one, in my opinion, is still really, really nice. Like this aluminum or something kind of finished. I don't know exactly what this metal is, but it seems aluminum, either aluminum or stainless, but my guess is aluminum because this kind of looks like stainless, but usually I think it's aluminum. I'm just gonna go with aluminum. You just wanna snug this, don't get it too tight. I mean, I got it pretty tight, but YOLO. I don't think you have to shake this. Pretty sure you don't, because it'll probably explode if you shake it too much. With all the pressure. Alright. Basically, you get it, your cable in the tool, and there's this little hole right here. And you're going to spray down in there, and then you keep working your cable up and down. And it's kind of messy, so you do want to probably get some rags and stuff, but I don't have any at the moment, so. And you're just going to keep spraying this until you get the spray to start coming out of the bottom. Which mine, of course, is a pit bike. The clutch cables on the pit bikes have this little brake in them. And that's... So, what I do is I just do it in two parts. Because I don't know how else to do it. Probably should have tightened that a little bit better. Because there's lube coming out everywhere. Yes, lube. But already I can feel a big difference from how it was before. I'm still not seeing any coming out of the bottom, so I'm just going to keep doing this. Of course, you guys seriously should use some rags. I'm having issues without using rags. And I don't know if this stuff is like, if this like a, has a harsh chemical in it that could like, mess up your paint or anything. I don't know, I haven't worked with it too much. But I'm just gonna go with it, guys. I don't need this too lubed up. I mean, it is nice to have a buttery clutch, but I honestly don't, it's not that big of a concern for me and Trevor. Trevor's bike already has a weird clutch and he seems to like it, so he can have fun with that while I get a lubed up clutch. Yeah, I probably should really be doing it the normal way that it tells you to. Alright, I have pro tips from Josh. Get some duct tape. Preferably with not lubed up hands. I can't grab anything. Oh, this is gonna be a long demonstration. Oh, there we go. Probably should clean that yellow. I'm just taping this up right here. Damn it. Okay, well that plan didn't work. Yeah, that didn't work at all. And duct tape didn't even stick. Alright, well, I guess I'm just gonna keep having to do it that way. Just gonna leave it up one more time because I'm kind of getting impatient. But basically the idea is you spray it in and you keep pumping it until you start getting lube coming out of the bottom piece, which I'm getting lube out of the bottom piece now, but I'm not really getting it in the other parts. Well, I kind of am, but it's hard to do it on a pit bike one, but if you guys do want to do it on a pit bike one, my advice, either tape that piece together or just do it the way I did it, because it's still pretty lubed up. It's better than not doing it at all. So I'm going to go back to work. YouTube. So, obviously, video cut out. I don't know where exactly it stopped because I'm not hooked up to my computer or anything. But basically, all I did, I'm just gonna do a recap of the whole thing just in case. Got the bars on from the old bike. Took apart the throttle cable, lubed up the clutch cable. Have everything set up. Just need to connect the engine basically, and then I put the new tube in the rear tire. And surprisingly, whenever I did it, if you guys watched, I was doubting it because doubting that it was gonna work because it was so easy. It was like the easiest tire change ever, and I hate tubes, so I thought that I was gonna pop it because I always do. And turns out wasn't popped. I pressured it up to 30. The max on these is 66. But I only pumped it to 30 because it's gonna be a pretty much a drag bike plus. I mean, it doesn't really matter. 60 is rock hard. These tires, the compound's already super hard, so it's not gonna be great for a street. But I don't know about the front. I haven't tested the front, but these are gonna be good for dirt, which we're not exactly gonna be riding in because it's the drag bike. Which of course I told you guys I'm getting new tires anyway, so those will be on the way once I get money. Of course, money is what makes the world go round and what makes how you get things. You have to buy them. Unless you get them for free, which I doubt I'm gonna get brand new slicks for free, especially for this pit bike. So, I'm basically gonna. I have to put the sprocket on this still. Which I don't know if I'm gonna do the big sprocket from the Lonson, or if I'll do the smaller sprocket that came off this bike originally. Because smaller sprocket, of course, means more speed. Bigger sprocket is more torque. So I kind of like the ratio on the Lonson. Like it popped wheelies and stuff, but it still had some speed. I mean, it only made 39.623 miles per hour, so roughly around 40 miles per hour. This bike obviously has to go faster than that, which we're probably gonna get a new motor eventually because the Lonson, as we all know, I hate the Lonson motor. But just until then, we're gonna make do with what we can, and we're gonna put the Lonson motor in here. I don't know if that's gonna be this video because, I don't have my stands or anything in here to, or Trevor for that matter, to come help me get the motor out of the Lonson. Which in getting the motor into this is gonna be easy. You just gotta lift the frame onto it because it's so low. So that's it for this video. I did a lot of work. Hopefully you didn't miss much. Thanks for watching.